Hey dear learners of Russian, Anya here with you again, helping you out with any problems you might have while studying the Russian language. In this tutorial, I'd like to discuss a very common mistake even intermediate students make. Very often in English you need to say, I'd like to know if it's raining outside. He's asking if I like it. I don't know if he called me. Anything. So this if, very often English speakers especially, they translate into Russian as ЕСЛИ. But it's not ЕСЛИ. Let's deal with this problem right now. Let's look at this example in English. I want to know if he's home. So many people will say, Я хочу знать, если он дома. Wait a bit. What we need to remember is that every time if equals whether. If you can replace if with whether, I want to know whether he's home. In Russian, you want to use particle ЛИ. Look at this particle ЛИ. So the sentence here will be Я хочу знать, дома ли он? Where ЛИ is going to be the second element in the subordinate clause. Not the second word sometimes, but it should be the second element, where the first element, in this case it's дома, is in the first place. Okay? Я хочу знать, дома ли он? Let's look at more examples. I don't know if she has this book. Again, I can replace if with whether. I'd like to know whether she has this book. The second thing you want to think about is what is going to be the first element in this subordinate clause. I want to know whether she has. У нее есть эта книга. Or perhaps she doesn't have. So, in Russian, we know what to do. Я не знаю, есть ли у нее эта книга. Imagine I'm asking you, у тебя есть эта книга? Or rather, у нее есть эта книга? And you want to respond, no, I don't know whether she has this book. Я не знаю, есть ли у нее эта книга. Okay, more examples. I'm just going to ask a question in Russian and see how you would respond to this question. Он был на вечеринке? Has he been to the party? Он был на вечеринке? Listen to the intonation, because the intonation here is very important. I'm wondering whether he has been. Был или не был? So you want to say, Я не помню. Был ли он на вечеринке? Был is your first element. And after that, following this verb will be this particle ли. Был ли он на вечеринке? Ты идешь на концерт? Are you going? Not going? You want to say, I don't yet know whether I'm going to the concert. What would be your response? Here we go. Я еще не знаю, иду ли я на концерт. Иду ли я на концерт. And you know what? Actually, especially if you're in your elementary level, it's good to know another construction a bit more simpler. You can actually respond and say, Я еще не знаю, иду я или нет. And do you notice how this ли particle looks a lot like или? Don't you think it has this same idea behind? Иду ли? Иду я или нет? Of course, there is an alternation here within this particle ли. Good, another question. Ты видел ее раньше? Have you seen her before? Ты видел ее раньше? Listen to my intonation, because here I'm asking, видел или не видел? You want to say, I'm not sure whether I have seen her before. Я не уверен, видел ли я ее раньше. Or another option here is я не знаю, видел я ее раньше или нет. So whatever you feel more comfortable for you, this option or this variant, whatever is more comfortable will be correct to say. Okay, another thing I want to tell you is that about this conjunction if, that it can actually be translated into English as если, but only if there is a condition in the sentence. For example, I can call you if you want. So if does not equal whether, then you cannot use if. You have to use если, because it's a pure condition. In this case, using если. Я могу позвонить тебе, если хочешь. I think this grammar is not too difficult, but it could be confusing sometimes and just not comfortable to use. But I'm sure you can do this with lots of examples, lots of practice. You'll make it. Okay, thank you. That's it for today, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Пока-пока.